Hey kids, welcome back to Sunday School. Today's lesson is for September 20th, and our lesson today is about having a bad day. You know, we all have bad days, don't we? How many of you have some of these things hanging around your house? What is this? Do you know? Why, it's my phone charger. I think, yes, I have my phone in my pocket. When my battery gets low or my phone dies, I have to plug this in and then plug this into the wall and charge it up, right? We all have all kinds of devices that we have to charge up. Even things with batteries, the batteries will eventually die and they have to be replaced with brand new batteries. This is just a piece of life and living in our world today, isn't it? We all have to find ways when we have those times in our lives when everything seems to crash in on us to get recharged or refueled or plugged in. All right? So today, when we think about having a bad day, we need to know that there is a way that we can get our batteries charged, our lives restored, and it comes from a relationship with God and His Word. We are very good at keeping our devices charged up so that they run great, but there's always a day, like some days when I'm out doing something and I've been gone for a long time and my phone battery just gets smaller and smaller and smaller and smaller, and then sometimes it just crashes. It's done. And I can't use my phone until I plug it in and charge it up. Today we're going to talk about having bad days. We're going to talk about what optimism and hope mean, okay? We're going to talk about a guy named Job, who was a there's a whole chapter about Job in the Bible. It's kind of towards the, it's a little ways in Job, this much into your Bible, okay? Now, Job was a godly man. The Bible tells us that he lived in the land of Uz was the name of the land that he lived in. His name was Job. He was honest. He did what was right. He had respect for God, and he avoided evil. Job had 7 sons and 3 daughters. He owned 7,000 sheep, 3,000 camels. He owned 500 pairs of oxen and 500 donkeys. He also had a large number of servants, and he was the most important man among all the people in the east region where he lived. Pretty impressive character, don't you think? Well, here's what happened to Job. One day, Job's sons and daughters were at their oldest brother's house, and they were enjoying good food, and they were having a party, and then during that time, a messenger came to Job, and he said, "The oxen were plowing and the donkeys were eating grass near them. Then the Sabians attacked us and carried the animals off. They killed some of the servants with their swords. I'm the only one who escaped to tell you." And while that servant was speaking, a second messenger came and he said, "God sent lightning from the sky. It struck the sheep and it killed them. It burned up some of the servants. I'm the only one who has escaped to tell you." Oh, man. And then, while that person was still speaking, a third messenger came, and he said, "The Chaldeans separated themselves into 3 groups. They attacked your camels, and they carried them off. They killed the rest of the servants with their swords, and the only one who has escaped was me to come and tell you." And while he was still speaking, a fourth messenger came. He said, "Your sons and daughters were at your oldest brother's house and they were enjoying good food, but suddenly a strong wind blew in from the desert and it struck the 4 corners of the house and the house fell down on all of your children. Now all of them are dead. I'm the only one who has escaped to tell you. And after Job heard all of these reports, Job had lost everything. Job tore his robe. He shaved his head, which was a sign of mourning and sadness. And then he fell to the ground and he worshiped the Lord there on the ground. And he said, I was born with nothing. I will leave here with nothing. You have given to me and you have taken away. May the name of the Lord be praised. You know, we sing a song here in our worship. Sometimes it's called Blessed Be Your Name. And this is where that song comes from. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name. He gives and takes away. He gives and he takes away. Lord, blessed be your name. When the sun is shining down on me and everything is good, blessed be your name, Lord. But when there's nothing and it's dry and barren, Lord, still, blessed be your name. And that song comes from this book of Job. Job had a very bad day that day. His whole world fell apart. And yet he chose to kneel before his God and bless his holy name. To basically say, Lord, you are in control. I have no control over this. I ask that my heart would just be lifted up to praise you even in the midst of all of this. Job shows us what it looks like to make it through a bad day. We can make it through anything when we can trust God to help us, can't we? You know, in this day and age, we think, oh, if we've had a bad day, that's just the end of it all. But that is not the end. Our God is still seated on his throne in heaven. He is still in control, and we love him, and he loves us, and we can run to him in those places, and we can call out to him, God, help me in this bad place. You know, we learned a song in Bible school a couple years ago, the Joshua 1:9 song, Have I Not Commanded You? Be strong and courageous. Do not be terrified. Do not be discouraged. For the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go. You are not alone. God hasn't left the building. He's right here with you. So we can hope in God's help. We can hope in God's future for us. We can hope in the ways that God rescues us. You know, we don't come by this hope automatically. It has to kind of grow in us as we stay connected to God. So, today, I want you to think about that phone charger. I want you to think about Job. And I want you to think about how some things might be rough in your own life right now. And let's go to God in prayer. Let's pray together. God Almighty, you are all powerful. You are not surprised by anything that is going on in our lives right now. You're not surprised by this virus. You are stronger than anything that we deal with. God, we just come to you and we lift up and glorify your name, and we trust that you are going to come and help us, that we don't need to be crushed beyond belief, but that we can put our hope and our faith in you, and you will walk us through. There will always be bad days, and there will be good days. God, in both of these places, may we praise your name and trust you. Jesus, this is our heart's cry to you today. Amen.